entertainment and information to those of you who are young at heart. Here are your hosts, Lynn Peterson and Al Jones.
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart.
I love you because you understand me and every single thing I say and do. I love you for a thousand reasons, but most of all I love you cause you're you.
Hey, you know what? That song and the hearts behind us must mean it's Valentine's
Week.
Welcome to Young at Heart. I'm Lynn Peterson along with my singing cavalier.
I'm Al Jones.
Yay.
And the singing one.
The singing one with the twang.
That's
sure
right.
It was pretty and I sure appreciate the song.
Thank you very much.
You're
thank
welcome.
You. Thank you very much. Thank
well, you're
thank
wearing
you
pink. You look very dapper today. I wore a little bit of red and we have to tell you that, you know, Valentine's falls on a Monday this year.
That's right.
So we're just going to celebrate the whole week.
That's right. We're going to do that.
And you'll see these hearts behind us all week long.
That's
on
right.
Young at Heart.
You will.
Absolutely. We've got some exciting interviews coming up today and some exciting news. The new flyer for the Channel 46, 41 on TV is now out. Try to find this where it's not too shiny. And it's sent all around to Valley residents. And inside is a whole month's worth of TV listings, including where you can find us, Young at Heart, at different times. Thursdays 1 to 2 in the morning.
That's right.
Wednesdays 11 to noon.
That's right.
In the afternoon.
And the following Monday.
And the following Monday. So this show will actually be on Valentine's Day.
Yay! The following Monday from 1 p.m. to 2.
That's right.
That's right.
So
and
now,
don't forget the internet.
And, of course, the internet. We are on, you could go to KPVM TV, Young at Heart, and on YouTube, and you can see all your different favorite segments of Young at Heart. It's so much fun.
It is.
I sent it all out to my family and friends across the country.
Oh,
so
listen,
in
I've
a way,
done the
we've
same.
Gone national.
That's right. We are national. And so, folks,
in our own heads.
Being that we are national, that means that reality is coming.
That's right.
That's right.
What the heck does that
Young
mean?
Young at Heart reality show coming.
Oh,
and we'll
wouldn't
be,
that be funny?
Oh, that'd be, listen, we'd be as big as Oprah.
Maybe like the Jersey Shore. Maybe
okay, Jersey Shore.
Yeah, say that. Is that hard to say or what? Jersey Shore.
Ooh, I can't say it.
It is, isn't it?
Jersey Shore.
Sure. And then we can put out all those self-help books out, like Snooki and Jay. What's her name?
The other one.
Situation.
And now the other gal. She was just on the Today Show. They've all got their own books out, and it's like.
You know, this would be something good because it'll be a senior kind of thing.
Yeah.
And the seniors would love it.
And you all would relate to us.
Yes. So we would go national and
write our own book.
That's right. Write a book. We'll be rich.
How we stay young at heart.
And we'll be young. Stay young.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. That's right.
And for our today show, we've got Shanna from Pahrump Florist. Showing all the beautiful artwork that she has done on vases and flowers for Valentine's Day. We have Miriam from Relay for Life. She's going to be talking about some events coming up. That's going to be really interesting. And, of course, our segment with Chef Bill.
Oh, yes.
At the Pahrump Nugget. And he did the wonderful stuffed mushrooms and salmon.
Mm.
Lovely. And we have Dr. Cha from...
She
I'm wearing my glasses
on.
Today. How's that? That's the first. Oh,
dental implant.
I wanted to say digital implant.
Digital implant.
Institute.
Duh. Institute. So they'll be talking about, you know, getting some pretty pearly whites.
Right.
Like ours are natural.
Hmm?
Oh, I have a tooth thing. Thank you. and this is very rare that you ever see me with glasses on. So, chalk it down. Minister Brown had all his remaining teeth pulled and new dentures made a few weeks ago. The first Sunday, his sermon lasted 10 minutes. The second Sunday, he preached for 20. But on the third Sunday, he preached for an hour and a half.
Oh, no.
I asked him about this. He then told me, well, John, that first Sunday, my gums were so sore it hurt to talk. The second Sunday, my dentures were still hurting a lot. Now, the third Sunday, I accidentally put my wife's false teeth in and I couldn't stop talking.
Ooh, that's a good one. That's a good one. Ooh.
Oh, me. What are you laughing at?
I don't know.
Okay, let's get serious. We've got a great show, like we said, and we've got some new sponsors, and they're all from Las Vegas. Isn't that great? The Vault, yes. Digital Hearing, Dental Implant, Cadillac. Ooh.
Yay.
Canyon Gate Medical Group. And, you know, we might even see some of those funky commercials from the Super Bowl last night.
Right.
We haven't talked about that. Oh, well, yes. What the heck. We'll see you right after this commercial message.
Stay tuned.
When you're in love, you bring flowers and joy. It must be the singing show, Young at Heart. And we're here with Shanna from Pahrump Valley Floral.
Welcome.
Thank you. Shanna's been on our show before, and we always love having you because you bring these incredible designs.
Thank you.
You know, guys, now remember, this is the Valentine's show, but the first time you will see this show is Wednesday before the actual Valentine's Day. So, Shanna, what should they do if they want something sent out of state or a special floral thingy done for them?
Well, they need to come in as soon as possible, because there are some really attractive and cute containers this year. People are going to be buying them, and if you don't come early, they might have sold out of those. So you have to have a substitute.
I was going to say, before you go on, I want to ask this question. What about the men? Do the women give the men, you know, the flowers or what?
They sure can, and there's a lot of men who really do love flowers just as much as the women do. But we do have something special for the men if their wife would like to do this. Which, if you like chocolate, which I do, I'd love for my husband to get one so I can help eat it.
Woo!
But it's a candy bar bouquet.
Ooh,
and we put candy bars like they would be flowers in a little container.
You did one up for us on the last show, and it was great because we were thinking Super Bowl Sunday or something like that would have been a great gift to bring to your host or hostess. And it's really the coolest thing, those candy bar bouquets. Mm. Now, those would be easy to do up.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
But still, just remember,
don't wait till the last minute,
especially if you're sending it out of state.
Right.
You are with FTD and
Teleflora.
And Teleflora, so you can send things out. Right. But you also have pre-made arrangements there.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes, we'll have some ready to go for anybody that wants to come in and
Are you in pain, or do you have something you need to say?
No, I'm just saying they're so beautiful.
I'm just listening and watching and said, oh my goodness. Do you want to let's show some of these off.
You show yours first over there, the little kiss. Yeah, that's a Hershey's Kiss.
Ooh, this thing's heavy.
And it's got a little tag on the outside that says... Hershey's.
That was our producer, by the way, who forgot to turn her phone off during our show.
Yes.
Look how
adorable that is. And the nice thing is, you've got a wonderful vase that can be used over and over again.
Yes, as a candy dish.
Oh my gosh, that is like just... And so this closes, the lid does close.
Yeah, it goes back down.
But look what Shanna has done. She's beautiful, beautiful arrangements. And not only just roses, but these are the carnations that can be used. And then
let's do the other Teleflora.
Okay, this is the other Teleflora. Yeah, can we see it? I'll get out of your way.
This is a Teleflora vase.
Here, you want me to put it in the middle?
Yeah.
There we go.
And then it has an actual real necklace.
Oh, it's a heart.
With a beautiful heart pendant on it.
Kind of like the heart from Titanic.
And actually...
There you go. And this is the Young at Heart heart. And look at these flowers. We've got some gorgeous
stargazers.
Stargazers, that's what these are?
Yes, that's what the pink ones are.
Is it a type of lily or what?
Yes, a stargazer is one of them. And it has just a gorgeous
The scent in
fragrance.
Here is so wonderful.
And roses, so you get a little bit of everything.
Yeah,
now,
beautiful.
Now, this one, I want to tell you, Teleflora has teamed up with Faith Hill.
Oh.
And she is going to have a collection, and this is one of her first.
So this is
for
her
this
design.
Holiday. She
so this some, is her design.
This is her design on this flower vase.
Now the necklace part itself. I should go get my glasses because that looks like a really pretty design of the way the links are.
It's a really nice necklace.
So we've got our love vase here too.
And that one is just kind of helps us remember how
important
Valentine's Day is, and that's
how
why we have
love.
It because we love each other.
Absolutely, and that's an arrangement of carnations, roses, and baby's breath as well.
Mm-hmm.
Then this little guy here, He's adorable.
He's one of our less expensive little vases, but on the vase it has little sayings like hugs and kisses.
Oh, it's hard love. To see, I think, with this light.
It has some little cute little sayings on it.
Sorry about that, folks. I just yeah, let's show them the flowers.
Whee! Whee!
Oh, goodness gracious.
And then you have all your regular, you can do roses, as few as one, as many as 12, as many as 36, however many you want to put in there, and we'll be happy to arrange those for you.
Gorgeous glass, red vase with all these beautiful, you've got some eucalyptus.
Mm-hmm.
Along with, now these are the lily, the regular.
Those are Asiatic lilies, so they're a little bit smaller than the Stargazer lilies.
Now, did we show this? This is another...
This is our Gerbera daisies, and they're really quite pretty. And then, you know, if you like certain flowers, we could even make them up exactly like you want them. So,
yes,
if you like lots of carnations or lots of this or that, we can.
But
put
again, at Pahrump Valley Floral, you need to get down there as soon as you see this show.
And we have lots of other suggestions. We have www.PahrumpValleyFloral.com, which is, you can go online and look at what you want and then order them. So that's important. Normally we close on Saturday and Sunday all day, but this year for Valentine's, because it is on Monday, we're going to be open all day Saturday and all day Sunday.
Which I think is amazing.
And Monday.
And what's your phone number? I mean, we'll give it again. We're not done with Shanna. But we want to make sure we get the phone number out there.
727-1011.
Now this is a beautiful one. This is with all the different color
We have lots of
roses.
Variety of roses. So.
And then the vase itself, you might want to hold that up a little bit, Shauna. It's a glass vase with little painted hearts on
down.
It. Oops.
Down.
That's,
down.
Yeah, we're having technical difficulties. Okay, it's like driving a boat backwards. Which way do you move with the camera when you're looking at a monitor? You're going the reverse way. But look at all these gorgeous little hand-painted hearts all over that, and the colors of the roses. I just love the lavender. There used to be a term for, I thought one similar to that, but I can't remember. I used to grow them, they were so beautiful. And how long does it usually take you to do an arrangement? So if people come in at the last minute, as people do, and they do want you to put one together, how much time does it usually take you? And you're going to be pretty busy anyway.
And that's why it's going to be hard for you to come in with something special to order.
Right.
Because we're going to have a whole lot of orders already backed up that we need to first come, first serve, sort of
Got
speak.
It.
But if we can work it in, we will definitely
and
try
so
if you want to take it with
simple,
you.
Just a simple little arrangement. Right. How long does it usually take? 10 minutes?
5 to 10 minutes,
to 10 minutes. So keep that in mind because, I mean, they do such a wonderful job down at Pahrump Valley Floral that, you know, you want to take care of everybody, but you got to remember that's one of the busiest time, is it not?
Mm-hmm.
To get flowers, so be a little kind to Shanna.
That's right.
Show her love.
Yeah.
That's right. Do you, versus the flowers for the ordering, do you have more women ordering flowers or more men? Or is it 50-50?
Mostly the men do.
Yeah.
The men do.
Yeah. The men really do on Valentine's.
Well, yeah.
So,
I think it's like it's inbred.
It's just, yeah. It's kind
of well, that's
of
what
them.
I was thinking. But
part of their job.
Well, that's true. But I was thinking sometimes you turn that around and you have sometimes
I think Al's
the women
hinting.
Do that.
And the women
like
are more than welcome to order flowers
yeah, women
for their husbands.
Are more
we
Al would love
they
flowers.
Do your boyfriends also, too. Yeah. You know, they love flowers. What would the women, you know, order for the men normally? I mean, if
well, roses always mean love.
Yeah.
So, you know,
even
and they don't have to do a whole dozen, but they could do one rose in a vase and make
still
it very.
Do that for
yes,
them.
They
sure.
and they could and, it, and they would they love it. They think that's really nice that a woman will think of them. Or the candy bouquet.
The candy bouquet.
Like that.
Remember, ladies, the candy bouquet.
Except you're on a diet. You said you lost some weight and you're looking really
suave. I did. But I'm sure a little chocolate.
Oh, broccoli. There you go. Cauliflower, broccoli.
Cabbage.
Cabbage.
No, a little chocolate.
All of that in there.
A little chocolate would be well.
Really nice.
Well,
and we do have Valentine balloons, and we have boxes of chocolate.
I was going to say, couldn't you do the same thing with like those little squares or something of chocolate? Just stick a couple
a in
with in. A with an arrangement.
Right.
Yeah.
But I just love, to me, this means more to me getting
flowers
than a card. We were discussing that earlier. Cards you read, so I'd rather hear it from your lips, how much you love me, or sing me a song,
or give me flowers,
or both, because
they are
just so
gorgeous. You do put cards on these, so little small cards
yes,
that say I love you. See, that goes on with it, put it in front of that.
Yeah, Happy Valentine's Day,
and the balloons,
Day,
the balloons would probably take place of the cards, you know, that say I love,
love you.
You.
Happy Valentine's Day.
And the
Happy
little hearts, the big hearts, you know, that say I love you.
Now,
also
how long
the
do these arrangements usually last? Over a week?
They should.
Yes.
Especially if your house is cool. They don't like the heat, so that will make their life a little less
happy.
Happy.
I like to ask the question because I don't want to share my ignorance, but what do you call these?
This is a stargazer. This
stargazer?
Is one that's open, and this is one that
stargazer.
Hasn't opened
See,
yet.
See, I didn't know that.
See, you've got one that's closed. Kind of
almost
open.
And this one's really green. Open. It might take a while for that
one. Stargazer.
So you can watch your flowers grow in front of you too.
Yes.
I mean, isn't that a wonderful
this
idea?
This one's open just since I've taken it out of the store.
Yes, it has.
That is so beautiful.
But you can tell that Shauna has an artistic bend with her flowers. And
thank you.
It can you imagine just walking into Pahrump Valley?
Yay! Get it right.
Pahrump Valley Floral, and see all these gorgeous arrangements. And the smell in here is just—it's a bouquet of
fragrance.
Fragrance. Yes, fragrance. It's so gorgeous.
And I want to ask another question. What are these little things here?
That's baby's breath. Or
gypsophilia
is what they call it.
Baby's breath.
Baby's breath.
I like that.
They use baby's breath in a lot of things,
yes,
Al.
They
you
do.
Know, like,
they do?
Corsages.
Yes, it's probably one of the most
We put them in like a dozen roses.
Flowers.
They have greens and the baby's breath.
But this is so beautiful, though, you know.
I know. And like I said, you've got to give Shauna some time if you want something specially made up. But they will have pre-made arrangements there. And just get down there because I'm sure they'll be gone.
Give the telephone number again.
Yes.
Telephone number again.
775. That's our area code.
Yes.
727-1011.
And that's Pahrump Valley Floral.
You got it right.
We just want to make sure you're there because
we want to make it right.
Yeah, we want to make it right. If
that's
you want to talk to Shauna, it's Pahrump Valley Floral.
727-1011.
And they deliver.
That's right, they will deliver.
And there's time to do that.
So get on down there, and we'll be back after this commercial.
Stay tuned.
Welcome back to Young at Heart. My next guest is Miriam Maxfield, and she is with Relay for Life.
Yes, I'm on the Relay Committee, and Relay this year is Saturday, May 21st, starting at noon, runs all night till 6 the next morning.
And that's here in Pahrump.
It's at Petrec Park, yes
right.
It is. And your own Deanna O'Donnell is our entertainment chair this year. And so if you have an act you'd like to donate, if you'd like to donate your time to perform, if you could think of some activity you would like us to use, because we have a lot of time to fill. We are going to have a stage. We're going to have a dance floor. We're going to have a sound system. So you are free to bring whatever you would like to come.
Now, is it too late yet to get teams together?
Oh my gosh, no. Please. If you would like to be on a walking team, if you would like to form a team, please, you can come to one of our meetings. You can call. Our event chair is Lori Wall, and her phone number is 209-0385.
And that's her cell phone, so
that's
a 775 area code.
And she'll answer, yes. And we do have a meeting coming up. Our next meeting is Monday the 21st, February 21st, at 7 o'clock at Desert View Hospital down in the basement.
So and the Relay for Life race, or it's not this coming Saturday, it's what... I'm sorry, I misunderstood.
It's May 21st.
May 21st, that's what
yes.
I thought. Okay.
We
so
do
we've
have
got
an event coming up next month, though.
Oh.
That's our Bark for Life. And that is a dog walk. It's like Relay for Life, only you walk your dog around a track.
Oh, I love that
and you
idea.
And you can buy a luminary for your pet. And it's $10 to register your pet. You can bring a goat or a pig. But no ferrets or cats.
Okay, so dogs, goats, and pigs are invited.
Exactly, it's $10 to register them, and we have luminaria bags you can buy for your pet for $5, and you can pre-register if you like at Acme Feed, Animal House, or the Pahrump Bakery.
And that's coming up when?
That is March 19th at Ian Deutsch Park.
Okay.
And we will be having a DJ playing, and we will be having a barbecue by the Lions Club. And we have these little costume parties, contest, I'm sorry.
Now, is that a 24-hour thing, like
no,
most of the walks?
No,
okay, it's
just
a day
in the
event.
Morning. It's
okay.
That morning, 9 to noon.
Oh, all right.
And dress up your dog.
If they like being dressed up.
Yes. And we're going to have a lookalike contest.
Oh, my goodness.
Between your dog and the owner.
I could curl my hair that
day. We have
day.
No contest. Oh, it's going to be, these are so much fun.
Oh,
I can't tell you how
fun.
Much fun they are. Last year, we had about 50 dogs last year, so we hope to top that.
Wow.
We raised over $1,000. And the monies go to Relay for Life, which eventually goes to the American Cancer Society.
Absolutely.
Now, I have a little event coming up that I know Al would like, since I heard him singing.
Oh, yes, he did sing at the beginning of the show. He's shaking. He's got his mic in his hand right now.
Okay, we have a karaoke contest coming up. That's a fundraiser for the Pitching Hope Walking Team, which Kathy Leach is the captain of. And you can contact her at 751-5323. It's going to be the second Saturday of every month out at the Tumbleweed.
Oh.
The finals are going to be at the Relay for Life. So you can go out there at 7 o'clock on Saturday. The first one is this coming Saturday, the 12th. And it's karaoke contest, Al, so I want to see you there.
Absolutely. I won't be able to come. I've got a wedding to do. I'm actually singing at a wedding.
Well, then you can come. You can come to the next event. It's the second Saturday.
Yeah. And then that's when Al and I could possibly do a duet. Karaoke duet with Al. What's your name? What's your last name again? Jones. James. Oh, he's going to change it now that he becomes
for the karaoke contest. He'll be famous.
For a famous singer that he is. Gosh, there's so many events coming up that benefit the Cancer Society. This is amazing. You got something else coming up?
Yes,
I'm sorry, were you done talking about the karaoke thing? It's just so much to get in about
well,
10 minutes.
Well, when I heard him singing, I said,
Oh, definitely. I think he'd be good at it.
Okay, our next event, I'm going to change hats and be on the Nevada Country Music Association now, Nye County Chapter.
Uh-huh.
We are having a Valentine's party coming up this Sunday, the 13th, at Stage Stop Casino.
Remember
that? You
can
only get there by Irene. You can't get there anywhere but go down Irene.
Oh, really? What did they do?
Well, the blag fell apart.
Blag fell apart?
The blag
Where
fell
have
apart.
I been?
Not driving down Blag, obviously.
I watch Channel 41 News, let me tell you. And just kidding. We had the new editor on a couple of weeks ago for the paper. I do read the paper. I didn't know about Blag. I was just joking.
Yeah, so go down Irene to get to Blag. That is Sunday the 13th. We're going to have a potluck, so please bring a dish to share. The potluck starts at 2 o'clock. And then we're going to have County Line playing. County Line is Rick Scanlon and Greg Smith.
Okay, they're joining forces.
Yes, they are County Line. They're going to play from 3 to 7. Uh-huh. This possibly would be their last public performance as Rick is moving out of the area.
Mm-hmm.
So please come for that.
Yeah, absolutely. Not just great musicians, but it sounds like loads
so
of fun.
Oh,
and is there a fee for that, or is it by donation?
That is open to the public.
Okay.
It's not a fundraiser for us.
Oh, okay.
We're just hosting the party, and thank you, Christy, at the Stage Stop for helping us with this. They
so
are sponsoring that for us.
Thank you for all of the wonderful work, probably, that they've helped you with
in
the past.
Stage Stop has just been wonderful. They are members of the Nye County Chapter, mm-hmm. Country Music Association. And Al is going to
be there.
Yes, he already told me he is going to be there. He is my date for the party, right, Al? I want to see your cowboy boots on because we're going to be doing some dancing.
Woohoo! And yes. Al does love to dance.
Oh, good. All right.
You know, that's what I'm saying. It's like he's such a wonderful guy, and it's like,
he's
you know.
He's a Renaissance man.
He is a Renaissance man. So we set him up with Miriam.
Oh, good grief.
I just love romance. You know what it is?
Well, it is a Valentine's party.
It's a Valentine's week.
It's
you
terrible
know?
To be alone
so
on Valentine's Day.
No, and you know, you can tell he's got such a great sense of humor.
Yes,
I'm not imagine you all
yes.
not getting along
and
having a good time.
So it's
yes, and he will sing songs to you while you're dancing.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Also,
No, they're going to meet there. Like all first good dates, you
all
always meet
date,
your
right.
date.
That's
the
right.
event.
That's right. So you have an escape
Absolutely.
There.
Absolutely.
We put out a bi-monthly newsletter.
You know we're going to be talking about this on Monday about how was your date with Mario? You're going
to
be well known.
That. Oh, my gosh.
Better be on your best behavior. Okay, we got more news about Relay for Life or all the good things to raise money for cancer awareness.
Well, the Country Music Association does put out a bi-monthly newsletter, mm-hmm. and we always feature one of our members on the front page, and this latest one, we have Jimmy D. Next issue will be Greg Smith.
Now, are these local people or within the state of Nevada or in our valley?
Nye County.
Okay.
And you can pick up the newsletter at Rod Miller's Guitar West store on Highway 372. They are a member. They have our newsletter there.
Now, why are they featured on the newsletter? Are these survivors of cancer or
this is the work that they've done? No, this is the Country Music Association.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Although Jimmy D actually is a cancer survivor.
Uh-huh.
But yes, we just want to feature a local artist each time, and just to, you know, feature the artist, and we appreciate them joining the Country Music Association. I will have these at the Valentine's party. Also, we will have applications for membership there. If you want to call me for more information, 727-3840.
Now, I know if there's so much information that Miriam's throwing out there, we will have all of this. Of course, it'll be superimposed over our little conversation, so we'll have all the numbers available again for you, and we'll do the rundown again. Gosh, there's just so much going on. I had no clue that you guys were so busy. Really are. You mean it. You want to get the money in there to help cure cancer. I mean, you're serious.
Well,
serious business.
The Relay for Life is so important to me. My husband passed of cancer, and the first couple of years I was participating in the Relay, I was the Luminaria chair, and that was so meaningful to me to see those Luminaria bags lit up in the dark.
I feel the same with you. I felt that same way. The first one I ever did was for my mother, and the symbolism. It doesn't hit you until you actually light the bag.
Yes, because you decorated the bag yourself
with
the person's name.
Yes, and then when you light that bag, and especially evening, and then you see all those bags lit up around the course, and it's
moving. What a release that is.
It is a release, and I just think it's a wonderful event. I've done them all over the years. Now that I'm back here in the valley, you'll see me out there walking.
Good, absolutely.
Yep. Yep, I will definitely do that. I don't know if I'll do the whole 24-hour thing, but...
Well, 18 hours, and it's a long evening, but it's fun.
And again, just remember, joining for teams and how you do it, you get your team. You could be your real estate team or whatever. Your business team.
KPVM-TV team.
KPVM-TV team, and you all just put your tent out there or whatever, and you walk with your... And it's you know, you raise money by... sponsors and things like
and
that.
And each team has a little event.
Absolutely.
There'll be events leading up to the event.
So we'll have all of those phone numbers for you. Great events coming up. The most recent one is the one for Valentine's on Sunday.
Yes.
So please go. Have a good time. And thank you very much, Miriam, for coming on.
Thank you for having me on.
Appreciate it. We'll have you again.
All right.
Okay. Yes. We'll see you after this commercial. Welcome back once again to our Valentine's show at Young at Heart. And what an appropriate name to have, you know, for this week.
It is.
It is. Now, our next interview, we have our own Rhonda Van Winkle, and she is talking to Dr. Cha at the Dental Implant Institute.
All right.
And they're going to be talking about things that go on there. And if you need a new set of teeth, let's go see what they have for you.
Dr. Cha, the Dental Implant Institute is really a beautiful building, and we want to know a little bit more about it. Why is it special?
Well, it's special because originally it was built by Sultan of Brunei, I heard. It was built by Sultan of Brunei's residential place, and it was then purchased by the circus owner Bill Bennett, and it was used as a corporate headquarters for Bill Bennett for several years. Then it was purchased by a person who was running for senator of state of Nevada, and it was used as a campaign headquarters. Then it was stayed empty for several years. Then it was purchased by my husband Leon Chen to be remodeled as a dental implant institute since 2003, and it was a training facility / dental office as a dental implant institute since 2003.
Wow, so the building really has a lot of history. So it was a mansion.
Yes, it was a mansion for Sultan of Brunei.
Now, you have a lot of things that you do here. What are some of the different things that are done here at this location?
Well, first of all, it was mainly for training facility for dentists. My husband invented a hydraulic sinus condensing technique back in 1995. It's been proven and tested for over 10 years. We have a track record of over 10 years, now 18 years, of success with hydraulic sinus condensing, which is an easier way or less invasive way to lift the sinus in the upper posterior region to be able to give implants under the sinus without creating extra trauma to the side of the skull, without cracking the bone in the side of the skull, so that patient can have implants under the sinus faster, less bruises, less additional without additional surgical time and the surgical site within 4 months.
Wow.
And that's what we teach to the other dentist, and we have a lot of dentists come in and learn from him and to give other patients benefits of his new technique so that other patients can benefit from all over the world.
Very good. So between the two of you, there's a lot of things that you can do right here yourselves. Now, just to talk about you a little bit, what made you want to become a dentist?
Well, my original passion was architecture. My father's an architect, and I was hanging around architecture courses at UNLV in the early 80s. I'm giving away my age. But I was also in love with biology and science, in basic love of my in subject wise, and I heard a bulletin board in pre-professional, club outside of it, and women in dentistry, and it says that dentistry is something that you can schedule your own hours, and you can have a family. And you can kind of schedule your own time, and you can be your own boss. And I wanted to have my own family and be my own boss, so I decided to change my career to dentistry. And when I look in hindsight, dentistry is similar to architecture. So it's like building structure, but in smaller scale.
Very
so
true.
I'm applying the same thing that my father did, but in smaller scale. So especially in implants, I'm working with small tools and same kind of mechanics as architecture or building, but in smaller scale.
And so you've been able to achieve the goals you wanted, a family and your schedule, hopefully most of the time, but your patients need you, right?
Yes.
So, but now where did you start school?
Actually, I'm a local. I started junior high school and high school here in Las Vegas. Mm-hmm. Went to UNLV for college, and I went away to St. Louis, WashU in St. Louis for dental school, and went to Northwestern for I'm a periodontist by trade. And I came back to Vegas to practice periodontics for over 12 years. And I changed to when we started Dental Implant Institute, my husband and I wanted to give the full spectrum of dental implants, which is from beginning to the end, dental implants surgically and restoratively from beginning to the end to the patients. So I changed, so not specialty, but I kind of do more restorative and cosmetics as well as surgical under this Dental Implant Institute at the same time. From surgical aspect to the restorative aspect and cosmetic aspect all at the same time.
Very good. Well, for those of us who don't know, what is a periodontist?
Periodontist is a dentistry who specializes in gum disease. So we gear more towards treatment of gum disease, which specializes in specific bacteria that causes bone loss and inflammation of the gums. And which applies to dental implants as well. You can get gum disease around dental implants just as you can get gum disease around natural teeth.
Okay.
So you need to take care of your dental implants just like you do with natural teeth. And a lot of people who have lost their natural teeth need to take care of your dental implants the same way. You cannot just neglect them just because you have implants.
Exactly. Now, you don't always have to do this for people who have mistreated their teeth. Some people have degenerative diseases or they're born with the challenge of really bad teeth and problems. Can you help them also?
Well, the best candidate for dental implants are people who have some people do have very soft teeth, which means their teeth are very easily decayed. They may have strong bones, but their enamel is so soft they easily crumble, they're easily decayed. They're the best candidate for implants because the bacteria cannot attack dental implants or titanium as easily as mm-hmm. their enamel. So they're the ones who can receive dental implants and can never be attacked by bacteria. So people who have good bone but they have easily decayed teeth, they can replace their teeth with dental implants and can keep their teeth with pain-free, healthy teeth for the rest of their life.
Very good. But
it can be costly, so it's something that they have to be committed to mm-hmm. take care of themselves.
And when you say it's costly, I know I'm sure there are insurance plans that do cover this sort of thing, but also, do you accept payments from people?
Yeah, we do have several payment plans. We do have Chase Health Care Credit, but dental implants not something that you can get it overnight. It takes mm-hmm. at least 3 to 4 months. Sometimes a full mouth reconstruction can take over 6 months. And we allow the patient to kind of pace their payments as long as their payments are paid, as long as their treatments are completed.
Completed, so, sure. Exactly. It's kind of similar to an orthodontist.
Exactly.
Because, you know, they're allowing you to make those payments, but by the time treatment's over, it's right. all paid for.
Yes.
So that makes it very helpful and more affordable for a lot of people.
Yes.
I know that we have a large senior demographic in Pahrump, mm-hmm. and they're watching Young at Heart right now, and they're getting to know a little bit about you, and there's probably quite a few of them that could use your help. Is there anything in particular with seniors that you'd like to say or anything you might be able to help them direct to come see you?
Yeah, especially for seniors, because if they're seniors, most of them probably have dentures. And if they have dentures now, they're wearing dentures that are maybe hard to retain in their mouth. They're moving around, and maybe they're using adhesives. And just at least 2 implants can be very, very helpful to hold on in their jawbone to help chew maybe corn on the cob or apples without pain, and it makes a world of difference.
Very good.
And it can be quite affordable. So that's right. something that we can help to improve their lifestyle.
Okay, well that's great, because you know what? Our next segment next week, I'd love to get into that with you. So I hope that everybody tunes back in to hear what you have to say about that, because I think that's really going to affect our viewers.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, it's like choosing a car, isn't it?
It is.
Going and wow. pick out your teeth. No, that's an incredible, amazing
it
place.
Is.
Yeah,
it is. So, quite a place there.
Great interview, and we welcome Dr. Cha into the area. And
that's right.
What else? What else have we got going, Al? We got another interview, don't we?
Yeah, we do.
And it has to deal with
yum,
food.
Yum, yum, yum. Yum, 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 yum.
Chef Bill over at the Pahrump Nugget. He did this delicious dish for us, and it...
It was good.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
It was
Stuffed
mushrooms and salmon. I think you'll see that. And let's go to that right now.
Welcome to Young at Heart. I'm Lynn Peterson with Al Jones. And we're here in the kitchen with Chef Bill and, of course, our favorite person at the Nugget, Dina. So, Chef, what are we doing today?
Well, today we're going to make for you 2 of our appetizer dishes that we serve here in the steakhouse. One is our stuffed mushrooms, which is red peppers, celery, and onions. We saute. Then we add the crab meat, a little breadcrumb and mayonnaise to bind it together, and then we put in the Old Bay seasoning and a little Tabasco sauce.
Oh, yum, that sounds
okay.
great, doesn't that?
Work? We pre-saute the mushrooms so they're ready, and then we'll put these in the oven and heat them up. So we'll start with that.
One of the things to remember, everybody, is if you want to make them a little bit healthier, use the light mayonnaise. I know some of you don't want to use fat-free, I'm with you, but the light mayonnaise is just as good, you cannot tell the difference, and that will save you on some of the things that you shouldn't have.
You know, I find though, if you sometimes do use fat-free mayonnaise, when it's cooking like something this, it really doesn't make that big of a difference.
Right.
But if you're doing things like artichoke dip and stuff, it separates.
Exactly.
But so, you know, I guess some dishes you can. But
sure.
There's nothing wrong with the light mayonnaise.
No, absolutely. It's much
low
better.
With that.
Did you buy that in the store? Light
yes.
Mayonnaise in the
grocery
store?
Store.
Absolutely.
Oh, I didn't know
yeah.
that.
So the next thing we're going to do is our ahi tuna, okay? This is a nice, beautiful piece of fresh tuna. We take that and we put it in our Southwest blackened seasoning, which is a mixture of paprika, salt, onion powder, garlic powder, cayenne pepper, black pepper, white pepper, cumin, oregano, and thyme.
Hey, I have a question on that. Even though you're going to put it in that, can you do it to someone's specification if they want it, not the heat as hot?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're going to put this in here.
Look at that tuna, girl.
Chef, what's the best way if you're a novice at this, you don't know what you're doing, how does somebody pick out a piece of tuna at the store?
Well, you want to look for this nice pinkish color, okay?
Kind of like the color of my top.
Exactly.
So, now this takes about 35, 40 seconds.
And are you doing this in the chicken broth or
in
oil?
It's a little olive oil.
A little olive oil, never hurt
also
anybody.
Remember, 2 teaspoons a day is really good for you.
And it's better when you cook it instead of taking it straight.
That's right.
Yeah.
Now all you're doing is pan-searing, correct,
Chef? We're just pan-searing this on both sides. You just want to do the outsides to give the blackened seasoning the
Can we see that, or is that, well, we'll just talk about it, and we'll show it to you as he... Now, he just turned it over, so you're
that
doing...
That was maybe
this,
a minute.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you're doing this almost like a rare.
Yes.
But
yes.
You can, I'm that, sure
that is,
if people
that's
like
how
it
you
little,
serve it.
Okay, but if people like their tuna a little... Well, more done. You don't get offended?
No, absolutely
no,
not.
No, it won't taste quite as good. You actually want to have it more on the rare side because tuna tastes much better that way. And the way we serve it is just a pan searing. So literally 2 minutes in the pan to make that seasoning turn that color. And you're going to watch when Chef slices it, you have a beautiful raw texture inside.
I want to show, too, that, you know, there's still more of the oil in the pan than what was used in the tuna, so it's not even like you're, you know, saturating it with oil. And so, you know, you're still getting the health party
absolutely.
Flavors.
Mm-hmm. Don't burn the chef.
I'll try not to burn the
chef.
Oh,
okay.
Look at that tuna. That's gorgeous.
It's fabulous. It tastes even better.
I bet it does.
One of the nice things about this recipe is it is healthy.
Right.
The tuna is very good for you. You want to get some seafood in as much as you can during the week. And the olive oil and the seasonings really help.
Now, some people worry about serving fish what they consider raw.
There's nothing wrong with it if it's a good grade seafood.
So there again, when you go in a, like the supermarket to find your tuna and you want to get a good grade of tuna, is it the coloring that really makes a difference?
Yes,
or talk
it
to
is.
Your butcher?
Yes. You want to talk to your butcher, though.
Yeah.
And make sure... You know, when the tuna came in and how long it's
Absolutely.
Been there. You know, always it's always good to be friendly with your butcher.
And I understand usually most supermarkets will bring in fresh, either fresh or fresh frozen.
Absolutely.
So if you get it within a day or two.
It's still great.
It's still good.
Now we serve this with an Asian salt. And what this is we take a blend of julienne carrots and daikon, which is a Japanese radish, okay. We take that and some red cabbage.
A soul.
And we
get your veggies in.
We add sesame seed dressing.
And how do you make that?
It's a blend of sesame seed oil and olive oil and spices. We mix it all together like this.
You can even buy in the grocery store, they have sesame dressings, like a Thai peanut or a sesame peanut. That'll be just as good, and it's a little easier if you want something fast and quick.
Mm. Oh, look at that.
Or you just drive over to the Nugget and you order this off the menu.
So
or you just
we put
go to
that
the nugget
right there.
Order, and take it home and say that you and did it yourself.
And this is then we top it with the wasabi sauce, which is a Japanese horseradish.
That's a little spicy.
The wasabi.
Yep, wasabi sauce.
I've got a funny story about wasabi.
And
my son.
There you have the ahi tuna.
That is so funny.
Yum, 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 yum.
He has cousin try a wasabi.
How are those mushrooms, do you think, Chef?
I think those should be about ready.
Okay. Can't forget our mushrooms in the oven.
We're talking about the wasabi. My son had his cousin try it for the first time, didn't tell him what it was, and it was the green wasabi.
Uh-huh.
Gave him a whole teaspoon of it.
Not good.
Not good. Ooh,
okay,
don't
so
do that
we
to
needed
anybody.
Our mushrooms.
Oh, it magically appears.
Helpers.
So really, it's not even the way you do it here. It's not bad for you because
no, this is
absolutely not.
Up to this point, this is absolutely very healthy. And Chef will show you the sauce we use, and I'll tell you some ways that maybe you can cut it back a little bit.
Absolutely.
But you could eat these just as is right now, and they would be fabulous because they have the crab with the peppers and the onions really good in there.
Then we top this with a little Alfredo sauce.
Oh, my. Okay. There goes the Alfredo sauce.
Now, if you would like to come here and splurge, that's perfect. If you want to make this at home and make it healthier, eliminate the Alfredo sauce, put a little bit of cheese, put it back in the broiler, melt the cheese on top, serve them up, and people are going to think you slaved for hours.
Or just maybe put half the amount on there.
Exactly. Or use
top
instead
it with a little shredded parm.
Instead of the full heavy cream, use a little bit less, a little more cheese.
And if you don't want to make the Alfredo sauce, they also have some good
stuff. And we put these in there with the broiler. Just for a few moments to melt the cheese on top.
There's a lot of Alfredo sauces out there in the grocery store that you can buy that are actually
pretty
good for you.
Yes.
That you don't have to take the time to make at home if you're uncertain or if you have a time restraint. So.
Absolutely.
I'm hungry. Where's your fork?
Oh, yeah, let me wipe this off a little.
The Alfredo sauce.
Can I use this to wipe off
yes.
Okay.
It's heavy cream, garlic, and Parmesan cheese.
Ah!
Did you hear heavy cream, garlic, Parmesan, cheese?
Yeah, because when I hear about Alfredo, I'm like, how the heck do you make that?
You know, there's a little
you
secret
could,
Alfredo.
Yeah,
too.
Al can make Alfredo. Why not?
So
you can also add a little nutmeg.
Melted the cheese a little bit on top. Pop a little fresh chopped parsley.
Oh, yum.
Give it that color.
I purposely did not eat breakfast today.
Why not? You're smart. You're getting better at this. You know that. You are getting better at this.
You're ready to taste.
Well, let's do this.
That's fine. Be careful.
Yes.
Now, one thing to remember, we do serve this in the steakhouse. The stuffed mushrooms not only come with the crab stuffing, but they also make it with a sausage stuffing with a marinara sauce. It's also very tasty, so it just depends on your preference. And this is probably two of the most popular appetizers. One very healthy, one sort of on the border. Jump in there and try that. You know you want to. Go ahead. Go ahead. Get your fork.
No, don't be a silly. I'm going to pick you off of that.
This is for our producer. Do you want one too, honey? Oh, I just talked with my mouth full.
We won't tell anybody.
Give her a fork.
I think they got it on camera.
Oh, okay. Well,
did you get that on camera?
Here I go.
He's diving in.
I'm diving in.
I'm helping him.
You're helping me. Okay. Here I go.
We're repeating each other.
Okay. We should do the same.
Okay,
ready?
One, two, three. Messy messies.
Mm.
You like the mushroom? Mm. Try the tuna.
That is incredible.
Try the tuna. You'll love it. Mm-hmm.
I love tuna. Tuna is probably one of my favorite fish.
Now, wouldn't that wow your guests?
Oh, yes.
That would really impress somebody. Mm. And it didn't take very long.
I can see making this as a dinner with maybe a salad.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. Oh, a nice green salad with a little vinaigrette.
We're just having so much fun, we're not even watching for time. That time to eat a bite of the sauce. Oh, well, okay. Anyway, just remember, come down to the Front Nugget anytime. They have incredible menus for dinner, and you're open?
We're open at 5 o'clock every night. We open to close at 9, except on Friday and Saturday, we close at 10.
That's right.
Absolutely.
At the Front Nugget, located at Highway 372 and Highway 160, where the telephone number is 751-6500.
All right, enough. We're eating.
Bye, everyone.
Yummy.
I don't know which was better, you know, but...
I'm still hungry.
I am too.
Even it was a while.
But that was so good. I mean, it was a great time. We always have fun over there with Chef Bill, and now we have a new chef coming up, and you'll be seeing him on future segments of our show. It's Chef Kendrick.
Yes.
He's new to the Pahrump Valley area, but oh, what a nice, sweet guy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. No, I've got to tell you, Al, that I really missed you. It was the girls' night out last Wednesday at the Pahrump Nugget, and Dina was telling us all about it on the show last week. And I got to tell you, Al, we had so much fun.
So much fun.
I showed up with three of my friends, and Dina was there as the host. And oh my gosh, the music was great. Anything from 70s disco to country and western to a little bit of hip hop.
So the guys can come to this also.
Yes, yeah. The guys can come, and trust me, we love having guys there to dance with. But we're not shy to dance with each other.
Right.
We're out to have a good time.
Right. Shake I'm going to be there.
Shake our booty.
Dee, 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 dee,
yeah, you just got to like all the different mixes of music because the DJ that was there, he just whipped
played
it up
everything.
All. Yeah, he played a little bit of everything.
Everything. Okay.
Black Eyed Peas.
Black Eyed
Yoakam.
Peas.
What's Yoakam. His name? Dwayne Yoakam.
Raymond Yoakam. Yeah, that's another one. That's another show.
I even Kenny
Rogers.
Some 70s disco they did. You can ring my bell.
Bum, 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 yeah. Ring my bell. Bum, 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 bum.
Oh, Pat, our producer knows
so
that tune.
Singing too, boy, I tell you.
The only tune that didn't get that I requested twice and never got played, it was Herb Albert's Rise. If anybody is not familiar with that, it was one of his greatest. And we did.
Oh, yeah?
We did the waist shuffle to it. It was so much fun. Oh, yeah. We've got a great show next week, except I can't see
put
without
my eyes. Put your glasses
on. Maybe besides dental implants, we should bring on an eye doctor implants. But we've got the Yogi Center coming on with our friend Becca. She should be coming on and giving us some good stretches to do on the show.
Mm-hmm.
We have, I can't read
Fencing.
Our, thank you. I keep telling our producer she has horrible handwriting. It's as bad. She has a law degree, and that's why.
Yeah. From Westcare.
Westcare.
And the kids.
And the kids. So she's going to be talking about, more nugget cooking.
Yes.
And that's the one that we're going to be with Chef Kendrick, I believe.
Yes.
Oh, my God. He did this tuna. What are we doing?
He did chicken.
When was the tuna? Did we do the tuna already?
That was earlier.
Long ago.
Well, you can see the impression it made on me. It was so good.
Right.
We have Canyon Gate. Hold on. Medical group. And they're here in the valley. We'll
good
see
night,
you next week, folks.
Good night, folks.
Have a great Valentine's Day. We'll see ya.
Join Lynn and Al next week for another entertaining and informative hour of Young at Heart. Have a good day.
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart.